Look what I get to pass, guys. Look what I get to pass. Nice.
Good day, Domic Nation, and welcome to the vlog. It is April 1st. Absolutely fantastic. We made it through March. It is a gloomy start of the month. Check it out. Even the cat's not happy. Gloomy. Not happy. And anyway, as you can see, I'm wearing my Buffalo Bills shirt because I'm heading off as soon as I'm finished my vlog. It's 20 after 8. I'm heading off to Buffalo to do probably two reviews. I'm going to do Burger King has the Red Whopper, Angry Whopper, the angriest Whopper ever. And somebody also emailed me and told me about Arby's has new Euros or Gyros, whatever you want to call them. I think they're called Euros. And so they have two kinds. I'll probably buy both of them, but I won't be able to obviously eat everything. So I'm going to be eating that burger, which is probably about 900 calories. And then each of those things is probably about 400, 500 calories. So I really don't want to eat all that food. So maybe I'll just get 1 euro. I wanted to kind of compare them. I just won't be able to eat them all. That's fine. Yeah, we'll do that. So right now I'm just compressing the finishing up yesterday's vlog thing and happy birthday shout outs. And I've got my Nexus card happening. I got my charger. I got my children's tray. And we'll be heading out soon. As soon as I get this, if I'm finished by 9, I'll be super happy, like uploaded and everything. I got the thumbnail done. Sweet! So the video is still uploading. It's about a 19-minute video, so I kind of underestimated how long it would upload, and then it has to compress on top of that. So while that's doing that, I am going to brush my teeth, get ready to go, and pack the car, and then at the last second share it across my... I cheated last night, sorry. Just a small bowl, just to get the fix out of my mouth. I forget what I was saying. Just get everything ready, and then yeah, and then share it on my social media, and then get the hell out of here. Gotta go. All right, so let's pack up. We are on our way. We got our bag of goodies, our water, Nexus Pass, wallet, GPS, cell phone, Ken. We are good to go. I think I pretty much got everything. For a second there, I thought I forgot my vlogging camera. Wasn't exactly sure where it was because I'm wearing a different jacket today, and it was in a pocket. It's in a pocket. The pockets on these seem to be further away than on my leather jacket. Leather jacket, I can just tap my side and oh, there it is. And anyway, so I felt like I had forgot it for a second, which would have been not disastrous because I just turn around, go back and get it. But if I was halfway to Buffalo, actually I'm not going to Buffalo. I don't know why I keep calling it Buffalo. I'm going to New York. Niagara Falls, New York. Both restaurants are in Niagara Falls, New York, so. But I'm wearing the Buffalo jersey because it's almost Buffalo. We are down in King City. We're really close to my normal Tim Hortons stop area. And on the way home, might stop in at the Tim Hortons that Pamela works at, because she's been bugging me every time I go out to Buffalo, but I'm always like in a rush to get back home, so I usually don't, and I can't wait till Hamilton to get my first coffee for the day. I have to get one here, so, and I don't usually like doing two coffees in a day, but on the way home I might drop by Pam's Tim Hortons. She might not even be there at that time. I don't know. We'll find out. Nice day. All cleared up. No more rain, hopefully, for the rest of the trip. Let's do this. We are here, people. Check it out. Cone Produce. Get out of my way. I want a coffee. Let's see how big. Oh my gosh, the lineup is freaking huge. Wow. I've never seen it that big. I'm gonna go in. Because that's just stupid. They're usually pretty quick, but I've never seen it that loaded. All it takes is one person wanting a breakfast sandwich and you're screwed. A regular parking spot. Yes. Oh my gosh, look at this parking spot. We bonus today. Let's go in and get something. Thank you. Moose. They're everywhere. As a Canadian, that's as close as you get to a moose. So many people think that we see moose all the time and live in igloos. But we don't, and we can't. All right, people, we got our coffee. Put it in the holder. I'm gonna have to move my water because the cables for everything is always in the way. That, don't wrap my hat. Move that there. Turn it so I can open it when the time is ready. Try to put my phone back on its holder. Ugh. One-handed. Okay, stop bugging me. Agreed. Go to map. Nice. Oh. There's Canada's Wonderland. That big green roller coaster is 306 feet high, goes 148 miles per hour. And Ben and I did it 62 times in one day. The video is on the big channel. If you want to zip over there and type in Leviathan 62 or Leviathan Domic, D-O-M-I-K, you'll get to see us do it 62 times. And I got a whole bunch of other roller coaster reviews on there. Even the Hulk from Universal Studios, or it would be at Adventure Island, Universal Studios. Check them out. Say hi. We're living in a fancy hotel, California. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. Mirrors on the ceiling. You pick champagne on ice, and she said, we're all just prisoners here. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. In the master's chambers, we gathered for the feast. They stab it with their steely knives, but they just can't kill the beast. Ooh, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Last thing I remember, I was running for the door. I had to find the passage back to the place. Do it. Relax, said the nightmare. We are programmed to receive. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave. I was just reminded by Dank George, which is his handle on Instagram, that it technically is my 6th birthday for food reviews. Technically, I'd launched the Tim Hortons breakfast sandwich 6 years ago today, and that kind of started the whole food review thing. So happy birthday to KBD Productions TV. Thanks, Dank George, for reminding me. Somebody else also reminded me and said you should be doing a special birthday review at Tim Hortons or something, and I just don't have time to do it. I didn't think ahead far enough to do that. Unfortunately, it would have been a great idea to launch that video today. Anyway, so technically 6 years ago today was my first food review. I'm not sure if I did a drink review before this or after this, which was the Jolt Cola. And I can't remember off the top of my head which one I did first, but I guess technically that was a drink review as opposed to a food review. And I think the other one was, it was more like, it wasn't really a review. It was more like, hey guys, what do you drink on a Monday morning? This is what I like drinking on a Monday morning back in the day. Anyway, so once again, thanks Dank George on Instagram. You rock. I am heading over the Hamilton Bridge. There's Hamilton way over there. It's an industrial city. Well, that part of it is anyway. That's why they got a bad rap for being polluted and stuff, because this is the only thing you see of Hamilton as you drive past it on the highway. And there's a really cool bridge that some guy who was drunk driving a dump truck hit it with his bucket up. He was drunk and left the bucket up and drove into the bridge. I don't know how many millions of dollars in damage he caused. Anyway, so again, there's Hamilton. Lake Ontario. And you can technically see Toronto from here if I had a different kind of camera.
Feet that hardly make no sound, walking on the moon. Some, they say, I'm wishing my days away. No way, believe it's the price I pay. Some say, tomorrow's another day. No way, may as well play. Walking on the moon. I hope my leg don't break. Walking on the moon. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up, yo, yo, yo. Keep it up, yo, yo, yo. To keep it up, yo, yo, yo. To keep it up, yo, yo, yo. Yo, yo, yo.
We are at the border crossing. This is the part where you just drive through. I believe I have to show my Nexus card when I get to the other side. It's usually not that far off. I don't usually come through this way. This is kind of going north, cutting across the north end of Niagara Falls, New York. So I didn't have to drive as far south. And that's where Burger King and the Arby's are, which is great that they're both together. Big bump. Canada. No, I want to go to US. I just came from Canada. Silly questions. So there's a little bit of a lineup coming back. Hope that's not there when I come back. Look at that cloud. Jeez. That is crazy looking cloud, man. That's like end of the world cloud. I want Nexus Lane. Nexus! There's nobody here, of course. I want to be able to pass everybody. There's no Nexus Lane. What the hell? I'm gonna do this one. Nexus Pass. Good day.
Hello. What's your citizenship?
Canadian.
Purpose of the trip?
Just going over for lunch.
Where?
Burger King.
You came to the U.S. just to go to Burger King?
Yeah, they got the Red Whopper. Gotta try it.
Good day.
Thank you, sir. You're coming to the United States just to eat at Burger King? Yes, I am, dumbass Canadian. I'm surprised they just don't tase me right on the spot, because I would. Oh, here's that bald guy again, with the funny looking Van Dyke on his face. I love New York. Nice sign. 6 kilometers to go. See, I didn't lie. I'm going over for lunch. I don't understand don't people go over just for lunch? Last time when I came across and I said I was going to the Anchor Bar, it was like, have fun. And so that was kind of like a no-brainer, but just to go over for Burger King, I guess it's a little more
what? He didn't seem that happy. Whereas everybody else that I've told that I'm just going over for lunch, either smiled, laughed, said had a good time or whatever. So I don't know. Some people have to put on the act. Where are you going, sir? Cool. All right, this is exit 23. I'm heading west.
Keep 182. Right,
there's a Wendy's right here. And then I think just down the street is the...
Turn right, then turn left.
Oh, I was supposed to turn right there. Dang nabbit. All right, I figured it out. I gotta turn right on Military Road.
Turn right.
I know. She's so bossy. There's Mighty Taco. Gotta do something at Mighty Taco sometime. And there's the Burger King. And it's the same one I did the
arriving at destination
Halloween Whopper. There she is, people. Let's see if we can manage a turn. I want to get out quickly, go to the washroom, wash my hands and stuff, and then I'll set my cameras up. And then looks like there's ample parking, which is good. Lots of space. Okay. Let's do this. All right, just got inside, washed up, went to the washroom, washed up the hands and stuff. Now I just got to get into a better location before I set up my gear so people don't just stand there, sit there and stare at you. Those guys are gonna go through really fast. Okay, they're not gonna hit me good. So I don't wanna get into it. The light standard is down. Just kinda wanna be out of everybody's way right here. This is a good spot. I'll put this up last, obviously, after I get my food. Stay. So we'll get all of our gear out, set it all up, and I'll be right back. Another setup by Ken Domick. I'm going to take this one down. This is my GPS thing. So I'm going to be needing my mic. Make sure you turn it on. I'm using the Rode. You got to spit on it, people, or it won't stick properly. Nothing worse than your mic falling off right in the middle of a shoot. And it's happened. That's how I know. You can also do that. Let's go a little bit over to the left, right a bit more today. See what happens. Change it up a bit. I try. We need our two lights. Light number one. Light number two. Perfect. These are newer suction cups, so they work really well right off the top. I don't think I need anything else from the bag. Nope. So I'm going to change it up again and make this GoPro wide angle. And again, I'm using my Crown Royal bags to help shade the sun just in case it comes out, because it's happened. Plug in my microphone. There we go. Make sure it's angled the way I want it to be angled. The only problem with this cell phone holder thing is it slowly tips. That one does too. It doesn't slowly tip, it vibrates is what I meant to say. This one's a slowly tip one. This one, when you start to adjust it, it like does it in increments. Whereas this one, you adjust it and it actually can slowly, if it's something's heavy on it, will slowly just start to move. So this one I'm going to change to wide angle. Got to go all the way around to wrench. I want mode. I want, that's fine. I want FOW. Go wide. I gotta get out of that. There's nothing worse than pressing the button and nothing happens. And then you press it again and it goes twice. So I'm gonna go wide on that so you guys can see the food in my lap or on my board. Because the last video, the one I put up today, the one that will go up today, that you guys will see before this video. So when I did the, what's it called? The McDonald's build your own taste, build your taste, create your taste. When I did that, I noticed that nobody could see what was on my tray. So I'm gonna go with the wide angle on this camera so people can see what's on my tray. If all else fails, I'll have to use another GoPro and like stick it to the ceiling and have it always pointed down as to what I'm eating. That would be kind of good. I'll be wearing my hat throughout this video. Gotta make sure it's on right, on straight. It is on right. So it's a touch just the top of your brow and then just snug it down a little bit so it doesn't change your facial expressions. So there we go, people. We got that ready to go. I got my light. Light two. Got this one, we haven't turned it on yet. And we're good to go. I'm gonna shoot this and then I'll come back to you guys and tell you how it went. And then we'll head over to Arby's. Okay, just finished up at Burger King. I've just shut everything off, but I'm gonna leave it on there and sneak my way over to Arby's, being extra careful because this is probably 100% illegal to do, but I don't want to take it all down, and Arby's is somewhat close to this location. We're gonna zip over there and I'll turn this camera back on once we're there. All right, hang on. Hey, we found the Arby's. It's right beside of Tim Hortons. I feel like I'm at home. So I'm gonna go in and ask them which one they think is the better of the two. I can't eat two of them. I don't have to eat them all, but I want the video to be good. This constant car is coming out of here. Come on. Come on. Let's see. I wonder where we can park in Ponderosa. 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 So I was in Arby's. They're having a bad day at this Arby's location, unfortunately. But I think they gave me some of these fries. I didn't ask for curly fries. So that will be in the video for sure. Everything is good to go. I'm just gonna use one camera just to simplify it for this particular video. It's nothing crazy special, but of course, because I don't think it's gonna be crazy special, it'll do really well. Something weird like that, you just never know. You can't figure it out. What's gonna do good and what isn't. Anyway, so I'm going to shoot this as quickly as I can and then possibly see how long it takes for me to get to a Cracker Barrel so I can surprise my wife with some Cracker Barrel sourdough bread for dinner tonight, because she was kind of craving that the other day. And when we came to do her Nexus Pass, I'm not sure why we didn't go over the border. Can't remember why. There was a reason. Didn't have time or whatever, because it seemed like it was really far out of the way, but I think I'm actually close to it at this location, so wish me luck. I am all finished up here at Arby's. They accidentally gave me two roast beef instead of a roast beef and turkey, and so I couldn't do the comparison thing, but you'll have to wait till you see that video, which I think will be out on for next Friday, and it might get bumped just in case something special comes up between now and then as well. I got something on my camera there. All right, so it's about 26 kilometers from here to Cracker Barrel. But Carol's worth it, let's do it. All right, I accidentally took a toll road, and as I saw the toll coming up, again, we don't have toll rolls like this in Canada, so we have electronic toll booths. It just, You just drive onto the highway. It takes a picture of your license plate if you don't have one of these transponder things, and just bills you in the mail and charges you for the video, taking a photograph of your license plate, whatever. But here, like, I had no idea I was going onto a toll road. Next thing you know, toll thing. And here, they give you a ticket. And then when you get off the highway, that person calculates where you got on, where you got off, and how much you owe. But I didn't know that. So as I drove up to the guy, I grabbed my $20 bill Canadian, because I'm like, I don't have any American money on me. I gave the $6 to Burger King. And I said, oh, sorry, I don't have any American money. And he didn't even look at me. He gave me the ticket and, like, was the most ignorant, worthless piece of shit I have ever come in contact with. I even said, you know, sorry, and he just looked straight ahead, couldn't be bothered, didn't want to have anything to do with me whatsoever. What a lousy, miserable asshole. Anyway, so, and then when I get off the highway, you have to give your ticket to that person. They calculate it, like I said, and then they tell you how much I owe. And it was only like 50 cents, and I don't have any American change on me. Again, I didn't think I was going to be hit any tolls, so I didn't even think of that. Again, I apologize to the American people for being, not prepared for a toll booth. Anyway, so the lady, as I'm getting off, I'm like, sorry, that's all I got is a 20. And she goes, don't you have any coin? Because she's like, I'm not sure what the rules are if you give the toll booth people $20 Canadian paper money, or plastic money in our case. But she's like, do you have any change on you? And all I had, luckily, was a $1 coin. And so she only made me pay 50 cents, which is awesome. But she was like super nice and trying to figure it out exactly how we should do it without, she didn't want to break this and screw me out of money, because American money is so much better than Canadian money right now. But super nice, awesome. I guess I'm in Buffalo now. Buffalo-torian. You rock. The guy at the other end, piece of shit.
Made it to the Cracker Barrel. One day I'm gonna buy a bunch of these chairs because they're so cool. We've always wanted them to have at the cottage, but because my mom rents the cottage, I don't want to put these at the cottage and have people wreck them. But they're very cool. One day.
Okay. Got my two loaves of bread. They're back there. Hoping I'll get busted at the border. And I shouldn't. They're just loaves of bread. All right, so I got a program. Where to go? Well, hey, let's go home. Hopefully it doesn't take me on a really dumb toll route. I guess I'll try to pay attention, see if there's any indication that I'm going on to a toll thingy. What is the bank around here? Questions. My GPS took me back onto the same toll road that I got onto. So apparently it was only 15 cents, just that little jog on the road. And so luckily, well, I guess the 15 cents she took when I gave her a dollar Canadian, she only gave me 50 cents back. So 50 cents American, that's fine. And then I went to give this lady 50 cents, 50, and she's like, it's 15. And I'm like, okay. Anyway, we're off, heading home. 290 West we are on. For those of you who know this area, my GPS is saying, go straight, Ken. Don't deviate from the plan. All right, let's go. Well, I hit another freaking toll. Dang nabbit. Anyway, so I'm going across these very cool blue bridges. Very cool. Very neat. So it cost me $8 to cross this bridge. Jeez. I would have swam. Wow. I wonder if there's any more tolls. Probably that's a bridge toll. Anyway, at least I have American money now. Had to give him a Canadian 20. then it trains. It's funny because it said a dollar for the toll, and apparently $1 American equals $8 Canadian. I don't know. What are you supposed to do? Sit there and argue with the guy? Just give me the freaking money. I'm out of here. Lesson learned. Bring American money next time, doofus. Like I said, I didn't think I was going to be hitting any toll booths, toll roads, bridges. We are going over a nice, pretty bridge. Over some nice brown water. Niagara Falls is over there. We're heading north. So I'm trying to figure out. Well, I think you can see the steam from the falls. I think. Yeah, that's it over there. Very cool. I just better not hit any more tolls. I just want to get home. So, ooh, the road kind of changed directions in an up and down kind of fashion. So we're heading into, we're at the crossing, border crossing once again. And there is a crazy traffic jam leaving Canada. Something I don't know about. Lots of trucks. Oh, I'd hate to be a truck driver. And that guy stalled or something. Jeez. Going over the big bridge. Can't believe how high we are up. All right, I gotta shut this camera off and we're gonna jump into the Nexus lane. And it doesn't look like there's a whole lot of cars here yet. I got my Nexus Pass handy very quickly, nice. Let's see. Yep, there's lots of cars, good. I can use my Nexus Pass. This is where the Nexus Pass comes in super duper handy. Look at all those cars. And I get to go right past them all. Yay! Finally, my Nexus card comes in handy. Look what I get to pass, guys. Look what I get to pass. Nice. Nobody, just me. Oh, I wish I had the camera on that time because this guy was suspicious. He's just like, so you came from all that way just to eat at Burger King? I said, yes. And he was just like, he didn't want to believe me. I just got to pay my toll. Just hang on. Is it better for me to pay in Canadian or American?
A little bit. Back to an exchange, a little cheaper Canadian. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
All right, so it cost $4.50, my last toll of the day. Anyway, so like I said, he was just really suspicious, and of course, I have the Arby's bag sitting right here, and again, he was just very suspicious. Why would you drive all the way from Toronto to go across the border and eat at Burger King? He says, there's anywhere else you went? And I kind of looked over to my right and saw the Arby's bag, and I'm like, and Arby's. And he's like, so you went over and had Burger King, Arby's, and bought two loaves of bread. Yeah. He laughed at the end, but the whole time he was just like drilling me, which is, again, the first time ever. Oh, well, from now on, when I go over, I'm going to try and meet up with somebody and say, yeah, I'm just going over to meet a friend and have lunch together. That will be probably a better excuse than just me going over the border to eat at Burger King. Think so? I think so. Pulling off the highway at Ontario Street, Beamsville. I got to get gas, and I'm going to grab a coffee here. Keep me awake. It's amazing how music can affect your mood, like, a lot. Because all the way there is listening to rock and roll and music like that. And I was all hyped up, ready to go. And I have a a slow song playlist on here, and I realized I was doing like 5 kilometers under the speed limit in the collector's lane, just like totally in the slump of a mood. It's so funny. So you listen to soft music and you don't speed. Well, I don't anyway. Let me know in the comments below how music affects your mood. I remember Jim, who did this syrup video with us, he said, "Oh, I was going through my old tapes or whatever the other day, I bought an album that I used to love when I was a teenager, and it was like a Metallica thing." He said, "About halfway through the album, he felt like he wanted to kill somebody, just for fun." So. And it's just, there's a Pioneer over there. I think we'll gas up over here, plus Tim Hortons, if people let me in. All right, so there's Tim Hortons, A&W, Subway, KFC, all in the same building, which is a great, and a Dairy Queen. Wow, everything's in that building. So just here at the Pioneer gas station, it's 94.6. Let's see how much cash it takes to fill up this sucker. So I got $39 in there, 41.2 liters. Like, it wasn't empty. I just wanted to fill up here thinking it was going to be less expensive here, but I think it's going to be cheaper at home. 94 cents. But I wouldn't be able to make it home anyway. But when I left the house, I think it was 93. All right. There is a Tim Hortons drive-thru, so I don't have to get out of the car again. And this person, I don't know if they know if they should move. Doesn't look like they know what they're doing.
Hi there, can I get you?
Hi, can I get a large double-double, please?
Sure, that's everything?
That would be.
$1.90, please. Order.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
So it seems like the Tim Hortons at King City, as far as I know, is the only one that charges $1.90. And I'm not sure if it's a franchise and they're allowed to charge more money or what. But everywhere else, even the freaking airport charges $1.90. So what's so important about the Tim Hortons in King City on 400? I thought it said 420. No, she gave me the right change back. All right, guys, we got a long ride home. I shut off my GPS because it's annoying. I know how to get home. I said no to get how to get home from the Cracker Barrel. Shut up! I am safely home. Yay! Again, some of the things I do as soon as I get in the door is to get the footage off the GoPros, start to charge them again. That's my 2 loaves of bread that I brought back, especially for Carol. She deserves bread. Then I had to go charge my lights, put all my stuff away so it's not in the way from everybody else. I hope you guys enjoy this part of the vlog, some of the things that we as YouTubers have to do, at least what I do. And this is just the best system that I like, is just taking all this stuff out, taking out my 2 lights. I usually put them over here. So I cleaned up that mess that was over there, put that over there, and then the cat bed over there. And it just seems like I did some work. And then that's pretty much it for the bag. And I can put the bag away until everything's charged up. I lost this the whole trip. It was under the passenger seat and I needed it pretty badly. So I was running low on battery power for my phone. But what happened was I had the this thing luckily in the bag, and so I plugged my phone into that and that saved my phone from being killed. I'll leave it like that because you can see the red light, meaning it's charging. Once it's all blue, it's good to go. Anyway, I'm gonna start downloading my footage, getting that up, compressed, and ready to start editing on Monday or on sometime during the weekend. Whenever I have time, really. It is 11:45 at night.
What did I watch? Oh, I watched the rest of The Wolf of Wall Street. So I watched the end of that with Carol. I just had a big salad for dinner because of the stuff that I ate today. I ate at Burger King and I ate at Arby's. So I'm still kind of, I wouldn't say I was full. I was hungry by the time I got home. But I decided to, basically I had some leftover, some of those beans that Paul made on Tuesday. So I ate a bowl of that and had a big salad, which is basically just lettuce and baby spinach, which is one of my favorite lettuces, or green leafy vegetables. And while I ate that, you know, Carol and I watched the rest of that Wolf of Wall Street. And once that was done, I just kind of went on the computer and just replied to a few people here and there, did some Snapchatting, sent out a Snapchat. I only got like 24 people sending me their Happy Friday faces. So basically I sent out a picture saying, you know, didn't get enough Happy Friday faces. So I'm not going to put together a video. I'll just add them into tomorrow's vlog, and which is this vlog. So at the very end, I'll put together all the Snapchat. This wasn't enough, and I don't want to put out an extra video for a failed attempt, but I still want to shout out all the people that at least participated in Happy Friday faces. Anyway, so I'm just going down to pick up Ben. He gets off work at 12, and then we will be going home. All right, it is 10 after 12, which is good. There have been times in the past that Ben's like 20 minutes in there trying to catch up on all the stuff that he has to do before. So how was work tonight?
It was good. It was really busy.
Well, it was a long shift because you started at 4?
No, I started at 6. So it was 6 hours.
How'd you get down there? Oh, yeah, we just went after school. Right. Ben has some news about Wendy's. Or are you allowed to say it?
News.
What's coming
sandwich
out?
Sandwich club?
Yeah.
Oh, what? Wait, what are we talking about?
Wendy's.
The Fresco?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they're bringing out the Fresco again in Canada. I don't know about the States.
So explain the Fresco sandwich to the people who might not know.
To be honest, I haven't watched The Wheelers yet, so I don't remember. But I know it has
a spicy.
It's like a lot of. It's really spicy. It's like one of the spiciest thing we could possibly make. I think it's at like the max school level, because it is honestly. It's weird though. 1 in 5 people I know don't find it spicy at all, and then the other 4 will find it like burning hot. It's weird. So maybe there's like 1 in 5 people that just don't like spicy. Because I've had like a kid one time who came up and he was like, can I get the ghost pepper fries? And he was like probably like 10, 12. Right. And he was with like his other buddy with they were scootering in Bradford. And I gave him the ghost pepper fries and made them perfectly. And he was like, I think you forgot the ghost pepper sauce because it's not on here. And we were like, yeah, no, I put it on. Like, I looked at his fries and it was on there. And he was like, well, it's not even spicy, not even a little bit. And I'm like,
spicy for some people.
Yeah, for some people, like, that burns my mouth off.
A lot of people think that just because it's ghost pepper, that it's going to be stupid hot.
Yeah.
Like, ouch, you won't be able to finish it hot. But it's like, why would Wendy's do that?
Yeah.
They just use ghost pepper to make it spicy, but not to the point where you can't eat it.
Yeah.
And as a new drink?
Well, no, it's been up for a while. It's the, we have normal and strawberry lemonade.
Normal. Nice. I think I'd like the strawberry one would be better.
Strawberry is really good.
Yeah.
What we've been doing is we've been putting the strawberry, because it's like a strawberry sauce, and we just put it in the lemonade and like mix it.
Oh, okay.
It's not actually like its own separate thing. We're putting in the Frosty because, like, about the summer that I started working, so not last summer, the summer before that.
Okay.
So 2014. Yeah, the summer of 2014, they got rid of our Frosty Frosty shakes, which is where you had Frosty, yeah, and then you had thing in it and it, like, blends it.
Right.
And it was so good. I got one, like, every time I had a shift.
I know.
But then they got rid of them at the end of the summer, and so we've been trying to recreate it by putting it and then mixing it with a spoon.
Because it's the same strawberry sauce.
Yeah, it's almost the same, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it's very similar.
As they put into the frosting?
Yeah, because when I tasted it today, I was like, this is like almost identical to what they did to the other one. Like how much, like what they did there, so.
All right.
Strange.
Thanks for filling me in on, or filling everybody else in on your shift.
No,
I always tend to forget to record after I pick you up. I'm like, I'm here to pick up Ben, and then the vlog stops, and it's the next day. So it's a big gap. Anyway, so we'll see you guys tomorrow. I'm going to end the vlog off now, because I don't need to finish off the vlog tomorrow morning. Ciao.
Peace.
Deuces.
Deuces.
Deuces. And now it's time for Happy Birthday shoutouts for Saturday, April 2nd, and they are Francis, Havard, Alex, Samuel, Jordan, Brian, and my very cool cousin, Kelly. Happy birthday to every single one of you guys. Don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section below as to what you had for your special birthday dinner, whether you ate in or you ate out. Happy birthday.